Welcome back. So what is PIP? PIP is a standard package manager for Python. So in Python, all utilities, whatever we use, we call them as packages. Now, for example, we will download Python related Selenium package. Okay. In Java, we call them as jars. Okay. Get me Selenium jars or get me testng jars. If you want to work with Java testing frameworks. Similarly, in Python, we call them as a terminology called packages, like get me Selenium package or get me Python testing framework packages. Okay. So PIP is responsible for maintaining for all those packages. So it will help you to install, uninstall and manage all additional packages required for Python. And one thing you have to notice here. So unlike Java, when you download one package, that package will be installed into Python environment. Okay, so now you installed Python in your system, right? This is where your Python is located. So now Python creates one virtual environment. So now when you download Selenium, Selenium will be injected into this Python libraries by default. You need not again import something separately. PIP will help you to download that package from internet and it will push that Selenium package into Python libraries. So that automatically, if your editor supports Python, it also supports Selenium because that is injected into your Python. Okay, but whereas in Java, if you carefully remember, you will download Java separately and then again you will download Selenium jars separately and you will configure it. You will have Java and these jars are independent. Okay, you will maintain two different instances. Java home, java.exe is separate and jar separate. But whereas in Python world, you will get this Selenium package and you will inbuilt push that package into python.exe file. Okay, so you will have only one Python. You should have Python imported in your project. That's it. You will not have separate Selenium import or separate any other packages import. All we will inject automatically into this Python main environment only. So PIP will take care of doing all that for us. Okay, it will also help you to install it from internet to your system. Now, this PIP comes by default when you download Python and that will be in the scripts here. That's why I told we need to give this path, because when you give PIP command in your command prompt, it should know where exactly that is present. So as we have given this path, now it recognizes PIP. Okay, so Selenium Python download. Let's see how to do that. Selenium Python download. And here you go. So this is their official web page for supporting Selenium. Okay, so they were asking that you can download the Selenium package with command called pip install Selenium. That's it. That's all you need to do. Copy this and come back to your command prompt. So in general, as I told you, pip is a package manager. With this, we will install all the packages. Install Selenium. That's it. Hit an enter and all the Selenium packages will be installed in your system. I already have that, so when I hit an enter, I would get something like a requirement already satisfied that I already have that. But for you, so many libraries will get downloaded when you say pip install Selenium. That's it. So automatically now Selenium package is injected into this Python environment. Okay, there is no more specific Selenium folder. It's directly is in now in your environment. Okay. Now, if you want to know where it have stored, I think there is a way in lib. If you go to site packages in lib folder, if you see your installed package here, you see that Selenium. So all packages now are sitting in main Python environment. Okay, you can confirm if your package is successfully installed or not. From the home page, you can go to lib folder and then you see if it is present here or not. Alright guys, so we have successfully installed Selenium as well. It's very simple, right? That's why I keep on stressing to everyone that learning Python is very, very easy. You need not have any jars and push it anywhere. It's very quick and straightforward. I just shown you that a link that where you can find for that pip install Selenium, and this is the command. Right. So I also shown if your package is successfully installed or not, you can go to this lib site packages, but from command prompt also you can check. Pip show Selenium, then it will tell you if it is present or not. Yes, it's there. You can see all the information of how it got downloaded. Awesome. And it also gave you a location where exactly that is present, which is great. So command here is pip show Selenium to know if it is installed or not. All right. So we have seen a number of ways to install Selenium and Python. And next is we need one editor to work on, right? Where do we write our code? So we will have one editor now, and there is one awesome editor which will help you to work on Python programming, which is PyCharm. I really love this IDE because this is super fast in performance and give you lots of access to the Python features. You can also do it from Eclipse, but somehow I feel that Eclipse is for Java only. When you come to Python, that takes backseat, and PyCharm is really king in any Python programming languages. You can just Google and everyone anonymously say PyCharm is the best editor for you to work on. So that is sponsored by JetBrains team. Okay. So there are two type of versions here. One is paid and one is free. So let's have only free one. Professional developers, I think, is a paid one. You can go to free community edition. When you say download, you see that community for pure Python development. We are not looking any scientific Python development, so we really don't require this professional, and just have this community PyCharm and just download that, and that will get downloaded in your machine. Okay, that's it. So again, you just need to say some .exe next, and that will be installed. I already have PyCharm installed in my machine. You just need to extract and open that. Okay. All right, guys. So that's all I have in this lecture. In next lecture, let's open this PyCharm editor and go through some basic principles before you start writing first program in Python. Okay. Thank you.